rock. This double platinum selling glam metal band is best known for top 10 hits Icy Red and Cherry Pie. They've toured with everyone from Poison to Motley Crue. Their latest CD is entitled Born Again. Ladies and gentlemen, Warrant! Everyone remembers Electric Light Orchestra, Evil Woman, Strange Magic and Telephone Line, among many other smash hits. Well, we've got the lights, and they've got the electricity. Give it up for the orchestra. The battle of the bands begins now. Please welcome your host, Meatloaf!
Hi, I'm Meatloaf, and this is Rock in a Hard Place, a unique show that features two teams of stars in a competition unlike any other, a head-to-head battle of the bands to determine who is the very best. Now, each team is playing for money, but charities will be the beneficiaries of their efforts. All right, let the games begin. Let's go over here and ask Warrant. Jamie, what charity are you playing for?
Skylar Neal Fund, TJ Martell Foundation. It's for cancer.
It's for cancer. Good job. How are you, Eric?
I'm good, man.
Okay, what charity are you playing for?
We're playing for the Elizabeth Glazier Pediatric AIDS Foundation.
Fantastic. All right, here's how the show's going to work. We're going to play a wide range of games designed to test your music and general knowledge, thus the name Rock in a Hard Place. I'll explain the games in detail as we go along, so good luck to both of you, and let the games begin. First up is Heavy Mental. I will ask a question one at a time to each team member. And if you answer correctly, you will get $100. But if you're wrong, the next person has a shot at the answer. All right. Let's go to Warren. Hey, Jamie.
Yeah.
Tell me about Guitar Hero.
Guitar Hero. Well, it's Cherry Pie. The song Cherry Pie is on that. And kids of all ages have been rocking out to it. And it's fun. When we go on tour, a lot of people come and bring their controllers so we can autograph it and stuff.
Right.
It's a great thing.
Are you ready for your first question?
Yeah, let's do it.
If you face north and then turn 90 degrees to the right, which direction are you now facing?
West.
Is it west? No.
No.
No. Hey, Steven, if you face north and then turn 90 degrees to the right, which direction are you now facing?
South.
Is it south?
I think you've got it, Eric.
All right. So let me ask you a question. Were you guys ever Boy Scouts?
No.
Did you ever own a compass? Okay. Eric, you face north, and then you turn 90 degrees to your right.
Yes, sir.
Which direction are you facing?
It's got to be east.
Is it east? Eric,
$100.
All right, going to the other Eric. Eric, how are you?
I'm good.
That's good. I know for a fact that you have played with some of the biggest artists of all time.
That's true.
Yeah, could you name a couple?
Well.
Or just one, even.
One large
artist.
Well, I've played quite a bit with you.
Yes, you have. Eric has sung on every album that I have done since 1981, with the exception of one. Are you ready for your first question?
Sure.
What rock legend and singer of Great Balls of Fire married his 13-year-old cousin?
Jerry Lee Lewis.
Is it Jerry Lee Lewis for $100? Yes! Lewis, at the beginning of Money for Nothing, whose voice is heard singing, I want my MTV?
Sting.
Is it Sting? Yes! Hey, Gordon, what is the first month of the year that has no national federal holiday? What do you think, Gordon?
February.
Is it February? No. President's Day and Martin Luther King Day. Two holidays.
In February.
In February.
Oh, cool. Nice.
You got that now, right?
Cool. Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. Jamie, what is the first month of the year that has no national federal holiday?
I'll go with March.
Is it March? Yeah! All right, Stephen, here's your question. The Fugees is a shortened form of what word which reflects Wycliffe Jean's Caribbean roots?
I'm going to guess refugees.
Is it refugees? Let's go to the next question for Eric. If drummer Ginger Baker had a baker's dozen of drum sets, how many drum sets would he have?
12.
Baker's dozen.
I'm going to go
Baker's
12.
Dozen.
Baker's dozen?
Okay, he says 12.
Eric?
Yes, me?
Do you know what a baker's dozen is?
I believe I do.
Okay.
13.
Is it 13? All right, Lewis, here's your question. What is the only primate whose average weight is more than the average weight of a man?
I'll go for a gorilla.
Is it gorilla? Yeah!
Good enough.
Okay, Gordon, the amazing musician, are you ready for your question?
I am.
Okay, here we go. Famous for singing Stand By Your Man, how many times was country superstar Tammy Wynette married? Obviously more than once.
Five times.
Is the answer five? Yes. Okay. So, Warrant, you are behind, so you get the first bonus question.
We are ready.
All right, let's see the category. Top 10 nationwide fast food restaurants.
McDonald's.
Yeah.
Burger King.
Burger King.
Taco Bell. KFC. Arby's.
We're
on the road a lot.
Are these restaurants you frequent?
We're on the road a lot.
Okay.
Subway.
Okay, Subway. Yes.
Dairy Queen.
Yep.
Pizza Hut.
Yep.
Quiznos.
Quiznos. There is Quiznos.
One more.
You only need one more. You only need one more.
Jack in the box.
Jack in the Box. No. How could Jack in the Box not be up there? Let's see what the last one is. Wendy's. Well, you got 9 out of 10 for $900. All right, we're going over to the Orchestra. And your question is, top 10 best-selling weekly magazines in the United States.
Okay, People.
People.
Time.
Time.
Time. Time. Music.
Us. Okay.
Newsweek.
Yep. That's a definitely.
Sports Illustrated.
Yeah. Good one, Eric.
U.S. News.
U.S. News.
World Report. Yes.
World Report. Yeah. Okay.
Entertainment Weekly.
Yeah. There it is.
It's a women's magazine.
So you got 7 out of 10. We need 3 more.
TV Guide.
Oh, TV Guide.
Nice.
All right, great job, guys. You got 8 out of 10. The other two are Star and In Touch Weekly.
Oh, Star.
There you go. All right. So after the first game, the score is Warrant 1,200, the Orchestra 1,300. Okay, Tidal Wave is our next, so get your hands on the buzzers. And what you see up here are blanks that represent words in a popular song. One at a time, we will reveal a word, and you buzz in when you think you know the title of the song. If you're right, you get $100 for each word not revealed. And we'll offer a $100 bonus if you can name the band that made it famous. Okay, here's your first song. Okay, two. That gives you a big clue. Train, two. Yes.
Last Train to Clarksville.
Is it Last Train to Clarksville? Oh. You get to steal.
Last Train to London.
Last Train to London. Give me another word.
Georgia.
Midnight Train to
Georgia.
Midnight Train to Georgia. Is it right? Yes. Terry, can you give me the artist?
That'd be Gladys Knight and the Pips.
Of course you would. Yeah. That's $200. Here we go. Next song. First blank. Oh, they're giving you big clues. The. All. All blank and the blank blank the ninth. of all blank and all of the night.
All day and all of the night.
Correct! All day and all of the night. All day. All right, for another $100, give me the name of the band. The Kinks. The Kinks. All right, next song. Here we go. Another done. Another blank done. Blank, blank song. Okay.
Another somebody done somebody wrong song.
Or something like that. Won't you play another somebody? All right, that's $100. For another $100, can you name the artist?
I want to say Glenn Campbell.
Is it Glenn Campbell? No. All right, you got a chance to steal. Do you know the name of the artist?
B.J. Thomas.
B.J. Thomas, yeah. Maybe.
B.J. Thomas. Yes, it is B.J. Thomas. Nice going, Gordon. All right, let's fill in some more blanks. Last one of you. Bad blank of blank you.
Bad,
Gordon.
Bad case of loving you?
Bad case of loving you. Yes, it is. All right. Hey, Gordon, I'll give you another $100 if you can tell me who sang it.
Robert Palmer?
Robert Palmer. Yes, it is Robert Palmer. Warrant, $1,600. The Orchestra, $1,800. We got more great games when we come back. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Rock in a Hard Place. Today's Rockers, Warrant versus Rollers, the Orchestra, are competing for the right to say, we're number one! Yeah. Okay, next game, seen, not heard, so you get your hands on the buzzers and get ready to play. We're going to show you a clip from a well-known music video, MOS. You know what that means? Without sound. And your job is to buzz in and tell me the name of the song and the band in the video. And if you're right, you win $200 for each correct answer. So here we go. Let's look at the first video. Eric?
Eminem?
Know the name of the song?
No, I can't.
All right, is it Eminem? All right, that's good for $200. Okay, Orchestra, you get a chance to name the song. Any ideas?
No idea.
Number one. Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady stand up? All right, here we go. Next video. Put your hands on the buzzers, guys. Steven?
The Thong Song.
The Thong Song. By who?
Cisco.
Yes, you are. $400. Okay, next video. Anybody got any ideas? Okay, Eric?
Counting Crows?
Counting Crows is correct.
Once again, I have no idea what song it is.
Once again, I have no idea. I don't think that's the name of the song. We're going over here to the orchestra. You can steal. Gordon.
Mr. Jones.
Mr. Jones. Okay, next video. People make some weird videos, don't they? All right, Jamie.
Mickey Avalon.
What's the song?
Hurt.
Hurt! Is Hurt the song? Oh, you got the band, but you didn't get the song.
Oh, damn.
I thought you got the song. All right, I'm not even going to look at Eric and Lewis. Gordon, I'm going straight for you.
You know, I wish I could say that I knew. I'm just not quite cool enough.
Mickey Avalon, what's Jane Fonda is the name of the song.
I know you want to do the Jane Fonda. One, two, three, four.
All right, next video. Here we go. They said something. Okay. Gordon.
Rufus Wainwright.
Rufus Wainwright is correct.
And that's all I got.
That's all I got. Okay. Got any idea?
My name's Rufus.
I think it's Chopping Broccoli, actually. Cigarettes and chocolate milk. Okay, that's the game on Scene, Not Heard, the score right now. Warrant, 2,600. The Orchestra, 2,200. Our next game is called Odd Man Out. And we're going to show you four pictures of famous people and read a statement that connects only three of them. First one to buzz in and correctly identify the person who does not fit the given clue gets $200. If you're wrong, the other team gets to steal it. All right, let's look at the first picture. Paris Hilton, Haley Joel Osment, Macaulay Culkin, Ludacris. Who has not been arrested? Eric?
Haley Joel, whatever that guy's name is.
Haley Joel Osment.
Must be Ludacris.
You got a guess.
Ludacris.
Yes, it is. Next picture. Tommy Lee Jones, Leonardo DiCaprio, Mel Gibson, Jamie Foxx. Who has not won an Oscar?
Steven. Mel Gibson.
Have you ever heard about Braveheart? Not Mel Gibson. You can steal.
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yes! Here we go. Next set of pictures. Jimi Hendrix, Beyonce, Johnny Depp, Jennifer Lopez. Who is not part Native American? Anybody? Go ahead, Steven.
Jennifer Lopez.
Is it Jennifer Lopez? Yeah, Jennifer Lopez.
I'm sorry.
Here we go. Next set of pictures. Prince, Shakira, Bon Jovi, Christina Aguilera. Which artist has never performed on American Idol? Gordon.
Christina Aguilera.
Is it Christina Aguilera? Yeah. Good job, Gordon. Good job. All right. Here we go. Let's see. Halle Berry. Reese Witherspoon. Oprah Winfrey. Michelle Pfeiffer. Who was not a teenage beauty pageant queen?
Oprah Winfrey?
Is it Oprah Winfrey? No. She was Miss Black Tennessee. Okay, Orchestra, who do you think it could be?
We're going to go with Reese Witherspoon.
Is it Reese Witherspoon? Yes! Reese Witherspoon. And we got one more question for you. Here we go. It's George Washington, Harry Truman, Lyndon Johnson, Gerald Ford. Which man was never elected president? Stephen.
Gerald Ford.
Yeah. All right, it's a tight battle, but the score is Warren 3,200, the Orchestra 2,800. And when we return, these two bands will put heavy metal to the pedal for the big finale. You stay tuned. Hard place. And we call this last game child's play. Why? Because it is so easy a child could do it. The game is to test your musical knowledge and your ability to play a very real instrument, not like one of those damn violins. Okay? This is a real musical instrument. Each band member will play a song on this high-tech kazoo. Now, your teammates must correctly identify the song you are playing on your high-tech kazoo to win money. If correct, you will each get $500. Eric, you get to go first. Oh. And this is your song. You got this? Okay, go. Play it louder. Give it some heart. Play it like you mean it.
Oh, that's how it goes.
Okay, here we go. You got a chance over here. Play it for him, Eric. You know it?
I don't know.
What? Nobody knows this.
I don't know what he's doing.
Go back.
I think I'm doing it right.
You suck on kazoo. Yeah. You know what? You are a great singer, but you can't kazoo.
That's what I like about you.
What I like about you. Jamie, everyone. Oh, my word. Okay, here you go, Jamie. I know that's a tough one, but I think you can handle it. Like I said, I think... Actually rock and roll musicians?
That's the rumor. The rumor on the street.
It is a rumor now. I don't believe a word of it. Forget you. Okay, the orchestra. Come on, play it for them.
Doing a damn good
okay,
job.
You don't know the answer. Sweet Home Alabama!
Sweet Home Alabama! Where skies are so blue.
Okay, Lewis! Okay, Lewis has got this.
In his hands.
He's got the whole world in his hands, Lewis. You are an expert pursuer. That's worth $500. Here we go, Stephen. You ready?
While I whip this out.
You ready? Were you born when this song was out?
I can't get no satisfaction.
I can't get no satisfaction. $500. All right, Gordon. Come on, Gordon. There it is. You know this song?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
My Girl?
Yep.
My Girl is right for $500. That puts the orchestra back in the lead by $100. This is the last song.
The last kazoo player.
And Eric, you get this right.
I really have to do this?
You're going to rule this world.
Okay.
All right, here we go. You can do it.
Okay, I think I know that one.
Row, row, row your boat.
Row your boat. Gently down the stream. Merrily. All right, folks, that's our game. Warrant won with $4,200. The orchestra was close behind with $3,800. Got $4,200.
Skylar Neal Fund, TJ Martell
Fantastic.
Foundation.
Fantastic. Orchestra, you didn't win, but you got $3,800 for your charity. What was your charity again?
It's the Elizabeth Glazier Pediatric AIDS Foundation.
Oh, fantastic. Okay. We thank you for watching. We'll see you next time on Rock and a Hard.